This video is sponsored by Squarespace, the simplest way to get a professional looking website. As smartphones gradually take over, we increasingly use them like Swiss Army knives, replacing as many separate devices as possible so that we only have to carry around one piece of tech. While this is generally very practical, one downside is that they can't always match the performance of every single device that they replace. For example, while using the built-in LED can be useful for, say, finding your keys in the dark, they can be comparatively quite dim on some smartphones compared to even small flashlights, which does limit their usefulness. So in this video, we'll be building an egg-like flashlight unit that can be plugged into phones to give an incredibly bright source of light when you need it. This is actually a very handy thing to have around, as it's vastly brighter than the phone's built-in light. It's quite literally a night and day difference, and is brighter even than most small dedicated flashlights. Now, as it's actually powered by the phone itself, it doesn't need a battery, which is why it's so compact. The way this works is by exploiting a feature available on most modern smartphones called USB OTG, which stands for On The Go. This feature allows USB devices to be plugged into the phone's charging port using a special cable which tells the phone to switch to host mode. When in host mode, the phone sends power to the device, which allows the device to be used and accessed, like this USB drive. Now, because this build does depend on USB OTG capability, the first thing to do is check whether your smartphone supports it by having a look at its specs. If it does, you'll then need a USB OTG cable. These are very cheap, and you can find links to them in the description. So the first thing to do is chop off the end which fits into the phone, and use wire cutters to expose the individual wires inside. We don't need the green and white wires, as they're for data transfer, so we can chop them off so that they're out of the way. It's a good idea to keep them at different lengths though, so that they will never touch and short out. The red and black wires, which are for power, can now be exposed and a bit of solder added to the ends to make things easier later. So the next thing we'll need is a microvoltage regulator. This is essential as it steps down the 5V output of the phone so that the LED we'll be using doesn't draw too much power. Usually resistors are used for this role, but as they throw away the extra energy in the form of heat, the LED would run much dimmer and the resistor itself would get extremely hot, which is why a voltage step-down circuit is a much more sensible idea for use with high-power LEDs like the one we're using in this project. Now, as these boards are a little hard to find, I have again placed links to them in the description. Once you have your board, the first thing to do is flip it over so you can see the input and output pads underneath. After adding a little bit of solder to them, the wires on the OTG cable that we prepared earlier can be hooked up to the input side, with black being negative and red being positive. With that done, what we'll need next is the gem in this whole build, which is of course the LED itself. This isn't the typical type of LED you may have come across before, but a special super bright 3W unit with a built-in lens and a heat-spreading aluminium base. Again, you can find links to it in the description. The solder pads on it are thankfully clearly marked, so we can attach some little wires to them, with red again being positive and black being negative. The other end of these wires can then be soldered to the output of the voltage step-down board, being careful of the polarity. With that done, it's ready to be plugged into the phone for the first time, but upon doing so, it's very unlikely to work straight away, and you'll probably see a very brief burst of flashes and then nothing. Don't worry though, it's not dead and is very easy to fix. Before we get to that though, I'd just like to say a few words about the sponsor of this video, Squarespace. If you've been thinking about making a website, but have been put off by either time or lack of experience, then they could be just what you need. For example, I've been meaning to make a website for this channel for ages, and thanks to Squarespace I was able to whip something up that looks professional in just a few hours. A really cool feature is that the content is dynamically resizable, meaning it adjusts itself to fit the window, and works perfectly on mobile devices too. So if you'd like to try them out, visit squarespace.com/perks or follow the link in the description for a free trial. No credit card info required. Also, you can get 10% off at checkout by using the code PERKS if you do decide to go with them. Right, so you're probably wondering what on earth was going on with that LED. Well, the reason behind it flashing is because the phone is being very smart and detecting that too much current is being drawn compared to the USB spec, which caps out at 500 milliamps. This is because we haven't properly set the output voltage of the step-down board yet, so the LED is drawing too much power. To properly set this is a trial and error process where you have to adjust the micro knob on the board itself in tiny anti-clockwise turns, reinserting it into the phone each time until the LED doesn't light up at all. With this achieved, the knob can now be very slowly adjusted, still anti-clockwise, which will result in the LED lighting up and gradually increasing in brightness. Eventually, it'll reach a maximum point and then suddenly turn off. This means that you've passed 500 milliamps, and the phone has again cut power. So simply backtrack the turn very, very slightly, and it should now be set so that each time you plug it into the phone, it should remain on consistently. As you can see, it's very bright, but we can't have all of this circuitry hanging out like this, so the next step is to use some glue to keep it all together. Now, to properly polish it off as a single unit, we can now use some moldable rubber like Sugru. I'm going to go with white, but it does come in plenty of other colours too, so feel free to experiment. Now, this stuff is actually useful for so many DIY things, so if you fancy some, I have put links in the description. When you're done, you can use your fingers to smooth out the finish and get rid of any fingerprints. Once it's set, the light is complete. As you can see, I've left the micro knob exposed just in case I need to adjust it in the future, but other than that, the whole thing feels very solid and robust. You can now keep it in a convenient location, and when needed, simply plug it into your phone for a ridiculously bright source of light. Now, as it's drawing 2.5 watts, it can get warm after a while, but as LEDs draw more current the warmer they get, it should push past the 500 milliamp mark and trigger the phone to cut the power, like an automatic overtemp shutdown. Pretty neat. It does take a while to reach this point, but it's quite a nice unintended feature to have. So, that's it for this video. I hope you've enjoyed it, and if you have, don't forget to subscribe. And if you do try out Squarespace, then why not tweet me a picture of what you make, as I'd love to see what you guys come up with, particularly if you do some sort of project portfolio. Other than that, I'm Matt, and thank you very much for watching.